Hello, and welcome back to Cutter Gaming. I'm picking this up actually right after we left off from the other episode. I know I said I was going to do a few things off camera, but I decided that I had enough time to record a second episode back to back. And thought we'd just take care of that. We've got a lot of miscellaneous stuff to do. And I don't like doing too many things off camera. Sometimes the repetitive things, I think it makes sense, but here we got to put some equipment away and do some things, and I just thought it'd be kind of fun to kind of wind down here together. So I'm going to fill this up with wheat and go feed these animals. And we can actually put the combine and header and stuff away for the season, since it's going to be a little bit before we need them again. Steering wheel the wrong way here. That's technically not here. I don't need to back up the square. Just gonna put some wheat in there. And we're gonna drop a little bit more in the pigs. And we'll be good to go. Yeah, I decided not to put the header back in the larger shed here. So I can put that loading wagon in there when we're done along that wall. We'll actually store the header on the header trailer. And if I could learn to drive, I'm sure you all would appreciate that. There we go. Oh, that took a little bit more than I was expecting. I like the little yard. I'm just not that great at driving, apparently, so I think really all I need to do is slow down just a smidge. One of the streamers that I watch, actually, the map maker for Michigan Farms, I've played on his multiplayer servers a few times when he was streaming and just generally talked to him, and he always has a saying that I was guilty of, and others, and he always used to say, drive it like you stole it. And that kind of sums up how I tend to drive in Farming Simulator. And I just found a completely new shed that I didn't know we had. Is that door open? No. Oh well. I'm gonna drop this wagon in here. Instead, or I mean, Birkin wagon in there, I think, instead of where I was planning on storing it, but we're still gonna put the header on the header trailer. I'm just gonna put this back up in the front here because A, we need it a lot, and it's very handy to have it right up front here. So. And we're gonna use the tractor to pull this header trailer forward so we can drop the header. But that's okay. I'm just going to carry more of these as well. See, this is what I'm really loving about this particular series of map, is we've got all these little odd jobs to do, as opposed to sometimes when I play, it's like I'm doing the same job for two or more episodes. Like, I'm really enjoying the change-up on the Michigan map, but I just got done recording doing two, you know, full episodes, which at time-lapse speed is several hours of harvesting sugar beets. And I'm just like, ugh, if I never see another sugar beet in my life, I'll be a happy camper. Actually, it wasn't that bad, but it was just, I felt like I was doing it for a really long time. I was doing it for a couple hours, so. We're here. I mean, in this episode alone, I've done several things, you know. Unloaded the harvester, I fed the animals, we put all the machinery away, we're just busy, which is just fun. Keeps things interesting. So, we're gonna pick up some of this straw here and hopefully get the lime spreader going. Wagon out of this field, but we get more than I expected. Probably because we fertilized this field before we harvested it. I can't remember, but I'm pretty sure I did a test in 19 and that fertilizer is affecting the straw yield output as well as the actual crop output. So. Definitely going to be good with the straw for a while, though, I think. The hay we can use some more of. Oops. Put the driving straight again. We got the camera. Let's see. I guess switch hands on the steering wheel. So I can get a better handle on our camera. Driving circles for a while, that's cool. So I'll split over here, get the other curve. It's interesting to me to have a field so close to the town buildings like this. Just not used to playing on maps where I'm seeing people, you know, right in the town. Usually you gotta like drive to town to pick things up and do things. Here, I feel like I'm actually part of the community. This last stretch for the straw. I only got more than half a wagon at least. That's actually good. I'm going to take this, much like our other items, and drop what we can in the. So I'm going to get the rest of my bins. That's barely anything. I'm not even going to bother going with my pigs. This hasn't even been a full day yet, so. And we'll check and see how much of this is filling up our, silo here, actually, out of curiosity. So, looks like we've got almost 100k straw in here, so that's actually pretty good. So let's see here. I'm just gonna go and park this thing real quick, and then we can get started on the line. So we're gonna try and create in this one. Nope. Turn the wheel the right way. The correct way. Hit the door. Actually, somewhat realistic. Just straighten this out one more time and we should get it. If I could get the camera to cooperate. I'm not even hitting the door. What's your problem? Work with me here. Just drop that fully in there. We'll never find it again. Be like, where's my loading wagon? We don't know. And it's time to spread the line. I should grab the fertilizer on those other two fields, but we've done plenty of fertilizing. I want to spread some line. Oh, it does dry fertilizer too. Look at that. That's pretty cool. Wish I'd known that before I bought the buildings. I will probably actually sell one of those buildings. I'll fill up all the lime. Let's go into the garage and sell the solid fertilizer tank. That's this one. Yeah. Boom. Done. Alright. Something new. I wonder if there's actually somewhere to get seed and stuff too that I've just missed. Or if they decided to be nice and add the lime station, and just as long as it was there, you might as well make it to dry fertilizer too. Who knows? We're going to start with this big field up here on the far side of the farm, though. We'll fold this, and I think I'll go all the way down to the other corner here. We'll start here. Just got squared up a little bit. There we go. Let's get to the edge. Oh yeah, this is working pretty good. I was worried, lime spreading always feels like it takes forever. And I've been using some really big equipment on the other fields, and I was just worried that even though these are small fields, that this was just going to feel like it was going to take forever. But this is probably perfect size for our farm. I mean, we'll have to reload it between fields, but this is not going to take very long to do. I was hoping for one that wasn't toe behind, but was like a three-point mount, like the dry fertilizer ones. But it wouldn't have held nearly enough lime to spread. So this is going to work really well. Just come up straight. Whip it around and go right back down, I think. Let's see, now that we're not under the trees, get squared back up with our camera. Yeah, those tree edges are just killer for me. I think some of these I'm actually going to end up chopping the trees down at some point. Like maybe join this field and the one on the other side of that tree line behind us together. I don't want to make the fields too big, but it'd be nice to have one quote unquote larger size field. Make actually a pretty good field to go all the way through this tree line in front of us and down to the road. I don't think there's a fence there or anything, so this would be a good field to do it in, I think. Maybe once we get cows really going and we want to do some silage as well, because it's right here. Easy to drop in the silage pits there, do some corn and fill them up, release a forage harvester for a season. Also be good for doing straw, get one big field going with that. Alright, well, there's our first field already done. We probably got enough in here to hit this one, so let's just see if I can center up here through the trees. Take this down. I think we'll have enough to do this field if I don't waste too much off the field edge here. Probably have to fill it up maybe twice more. This way, I think. Probably. Yeah. Well, it's more optimal than turning around a whole bunch of times. I don't know if I'm going to make it back to the farm to fill up. That's what I was wondering, if I could get all the way around the outside and end up back closer to the farm before I run out. But I may have overestimated my capacity ever so slightly. Fair amount of field here. We might make it back down to the edge. I don't think I'll make it back up and around the pigs, but I'll take it. Two, one. Done. Yeah, good enough. Let's fold her up, and the super nice thing about having all these fields right by our farm is it's not that big of a deal to go fill up the line again. So this is the other thing I'm liking about this map setup is it's super convenient. The driving is still not improved, but the map is doing its best to make me not have to drive all over the place. I'd really like to have gotten that grass field up on the top side of the farm here instead of the one down the road, but maybe we'll switch them out here when we get a little bit more money after the next harvest or after the animals take off. We'll go in cab to get through the farm here maybe. Just want to get back down here and set back up where we were. Another set of fields that could probably get combined if I decided I wanted a slightly larger field for something else. I like the idea though of keeping the smaller fields because we need a lot of different crops to keep the animals going. Not a lot, but it's nice to have a variety. And also when the prices fluctuate, since we do have a silo system, we can hold on to a good chunk of them and sell them. And the prices are better. which is very realistic, and I push the wrong button again. Turn that off. So that's the other thing that we'll have to do here once we're done with the lime, is check our prices. I'd really like to know if there's some of the grain that we're holding on to that we should sell now while the price is high. Just to make some profit, since we're on our way to having a lot more crops soon. And I'm also intrigued by the fact that we can take out another money on the loan. I'm curious how much more we're able to get, and if it makes sense to do that and try and get another field or something. Although fields are usually pretty expensive. We'll follow the top line back here. It's a little bit longer. Stretch. This did not take nearly as long as I was expecting it to, so I'm glad we were able to tackle this job today. Got the cruise control set. Let's just take a quick look at the crop prices. Oh, I'm missing stuff. All right, I can't multitask. Let's just sit back up here and go this again. Alright. Let's finish one thing at a time. I think that field in front of us is ours too. Well, we might not finish all the lime spreading today, but we got most of it done. And we've made a fair amount of progress on all the other odd jobs that need to be done. I think next episode we need to go check on our horse a little bit. Maybe I'll read up on how all that works, and we'll finish checking in on our animals. And then we also need to get going on planting here, season here pretty soon, so I'm looking forward to that. Got to figure out what we want to plant. Make sure that we can feed all of our animals, so come up with a crop plan for the year and plan out what we're going to plant. So I think that... that's going to be all for this episode, and we'll plan on just whipping out the rest of this field off camera and picking up next time, ready to start planting season. So appreciate you watching, and please leave some feedback below if there's things that you'd like to see me do, equipment you'd like to see me try. And as always, if you're enjoying the episode, please go ahead and hit that like button, leave a comment, subscribe, and we'll catch you next time. That's all for today. Kedirk, out.